Before inviting Mrs. Bulc...
Teach me to dance.
Just a video for you, please.
Dance? Did you say dance? Come on, my boy. Together. Let's go. Hop. Again. Hop. Now. Yassou le Verde. Boss, I have so much to tell you. I never loved a man more than you. Boys, did you ever see a more splendiferous crash? You can laugh too, huh? Hey,
you laugh? You saw how they all ran.
Especially the monks.
The third time was the best. Nothing left.
Hey.
Commissioner, from the old to the new. Welcome to Greece.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Wow, do you really need me on the stage? I mean, it says it all. You cannot be successful without a passion. You cannot be successful without allowing yourself to be happy and to really, truly believe in what you do. And I think you all know that. That's probably why you entered the shipping sector, and that's why you are getting engaged in one of the most exciting portfolios you can be, and especially for Greece, one of the most important portfolios that you can think of. And not because only it's related to the sea, but because it's also the sector that is developing. And in spite of all the challenges that it has, it's able to conquer them. It's able to overcome the obstacles. And it's able to find new ways how to address new conditions, finds a way how to adjust. And I hope you will keep that in your hearts when you enter this exciting portfolio at the full stage. Because it needs... Today, the global environment, lots of adjustments. And you gotta love it. You better learn how to love it. And constantly look for how you can imply your core competences and co-create this dynamic in the world. I love my portfolio. Just because it is so challenging and because it is really not allowing me to sleep, I have to train myself all the time, educate myself all the time. But because of that, I can see opportunities. And in every problem, I see a chance to contribute with my points of view, with my ways of thinking. And the good thing is that the world is opening up to that. Yes, you can see all the challenges around us. But please accept my invitation and really see them as opportunities for you to prove yourself. Not as an obstacle for not doing anything. If any time today, the world needs good people to stand up for good. And I'm sure that you have that in your hearts. Allow that comes true. And you will see you're going to love your jobs, no matter where you are, no matter what you do. And be open for a change in your lives as well. Allow life to challenge you and inspire you. I'm an electrical engineer by profession. But I worked as a computer designer and software engineer for many years in Silicon Valley. But then I came back to Europe and I worked in telecommunications. And then I moved to entrepreneurship and I was running my own company for 14 years. And then the situation in the country I know best challenged me to get involved as a politician. Only 19 months ago. And we got involved in the country I know best, which is called Slovenia. And we formed a party a month before the elections. And we won by the largest percentage ever any party won. And I had to become a politician then. Because my prayers were actually heard. So I had to get involved again. And I love it. I love being a politician. It's one of the best jobs you can have. But being a commissioner, which I became 5 weeks after I became deputy prime minister in Slovenia, it taught me that it is an extremely responsible job. It is a very honorable job, and it's a job that connects people. So please be part of an exciting world that is coming, that is asking for people who want to get engaged, is asking for people who want to get involved, is asking for people that see the opportunities in everything that is around them, and who are willing to cooperate, who are willing to co-create, who are willing to fight for a good of people and this beautiful planet of Earth. So don't be afraid. Fear is just taking all the powers away from you. Engage instead and help each other. And if that is a shipping, wow, you're privileged. That is great, yeah? But never forget that we are here to create a better world. Never lose optimism that we need. And you are the future, and I know why the shipping is strong. Not only because all the ship owners used to be seafarers first, as I was told today, but because the shipping has you. Thank you.
So welcome again. This is the Yes to Shipping that you can wear if you want for today to remember of us. Welcome in our country.
Thank you.
And as you know, Greece is number one in shipping all over the world, managing about 20% of the worldwide trade. And here, there are about 700 young people that they want to go on this sector and, let's say, move the country forward. So what was the reason, the first reason, we'll make the first question, why you wanted the first contact, the first dialogue in Greece to be with the young people?
Thank you very much. Because that's where the good ideas are. That's where the breaking through ideas are. And I have two teenage kids as well. And I love just to listen to them, because if I talk to them, they don't tell me. But when I just listen to them, I hear what the future will look like. And that's why I keep inviting you, dream. The biggest mind of 20th century, Nikola Tesla, he dreamt about every single invention first. He was able to test it in his mind. And then he just did it when everything worked in accordance with the rules of the universe. So don't ever take no for an answer. Don't ever take obstacle as something that will stop you, but always something that will pull you through, over, and beyond the known. That's why I just love feeling this energy. And it's through cross-generational cooperation. That's where the future of the world and the shipping industry is.
What I can also say is that shipping can have many directions, not only the shipping as shipping, but lawyers, people from the technical world. So this is why here we have many engineers, many lawyers, and people that they are also from other studies. So the floor will be yours, because she wants to have a dialogue. This is what she told us. I want the dialogue with the young people. And we preferred not to have the questions up there, but to have a live dialogue in order to make the questions. And we also have a translator that if the question is in Greek, then she will translate to English for the commissioner. So please, questions? We must start the dialogue. You must have questions for the commissioner.
I have a question for you.
Ah, great.
Okay, so can I ask a question? Shipping is really, everybody says that the job itself is hard. You go on the ship and you're away from your home for a while. They say that it's especially hard for women as well because of certain conditions that you have to work in. But I see lots of women in this hallway, and I wonder, what drives you? Why did you pick this as your future profession? What really motivated you that you struggled through all the exams and all these years of education? What is the drive that brought you here? Who wants to respond? Who dares to respond?
Yes, great.
The challenge of people saying that you can't do it, so you just can.
Perfect. Okay, next question, if you don't have any. I will keep asking until you come up with a question. What do you see as the biggest opportunity in shipping industry and shipping sector? What inspires you? Have you dreamt about some new solutions, new technology, something that you already see you will be able to create that is not here yet, but you dare to dream about?
The microphone.
I don't think I need a microphone. No,
you do.
You do, because we must have it also on the video. When you become a big manager in shipping, we must have what you said.
Can you listen to
10
me?
10 years
one?
Before.
Right. So the question that I have in this instance is basically what I have to say about the question that you asked is, there is no such thing as being able to dream about the future so much as being able to withstand the unknown. That is to say, when you go into the shipping industry, basically, I was born in Piraeus. I was born and bred, and I still study in Piraeus as well. So what I know is that from the nature of the culture that exists in the shipping industry and so forth, is that there is always an element of the unknown, and that there is always a specific thing which everybody wants to, you know, make themselves better. We compare ourselves to the others above us. That's what we call benchmarking, and that's how society progresses. Everybody likes to say, I want to become like Steve Jobs. Look how he made it. Or, hey, Michael Jackson, how did he get there? How did this guy get there? How did he get on top? And I'm still not on the top. So that's what motivates people, in my personal opinion, to achieve. And also, you need to also have, in my personal opinion, have it in you. Not everybody in this world is going to have an innovative personality. And unfortunately, that's the reality. But the persons that actually have an innovative curiosity are the ones who believe that the person who created the saying, curiosity killed the cat, is, to be perfectly honest with you, not an honest statement. Thank you.
Thank you, but allow me just, until you're thinking about your question, invite you to recognize this incredible beauty in every single one of yourself and one of you around. Please take a second and just look at your neighbor and see this beautiful, really unique individual who brought to this life something really special. And your duty is to discover this really beautiful, special thing and engage with it and create this world as a better place. And Michael Jackson and many others, if you really talk to them, they will tell you that they never looked at anybody else, but they try to engage with their own talents, create their own story, create their own world, the world that they want to live in. So make sure you don't look up to too many people because they're going to spoil you. Just be yourself, connect with others, and through the power of human creativity, create a really, really beautiful world that we all want to live in.
Can I make you a question? At the European Commission, because we also have the minister here, so it's good to combine some European questions. At the European Commission, you're in charge, and I'm also a European young leader, so I am from the people that they said yes to Europe because we believe in Europe. We are part of Europe, of course. We're Europeans. At the Europe, but we will fight to show you how Greek shipping, that Greek shipping is very strong, and we love a lot Greek shipping. At the European Commission, we are in charge for all the transports, interconnections, and the networks. You have come in Greece for this amazing Posidonia that we're waiting for you again in 2 years, because it's a great exhibition, and 20,000 people have come from 97 countries, 1,800 stands, great numbers. What the European Commission and the European Union is proposing to strengthen Greece capacity? We have Piraeus, we have the Suez Canal that now is bigger, we have more vessels that they can come through Piraeus to make the trading and then to go to Europe. So what do you believe about this strategic port that's called Piraeus and Greece?
Okay, let me be a European commissioner for a second. So the fact is that it took us a while to really understand the potentials and where to focus needs to be in order to keep European transport sector as a whole, which of course maritime is part of it, in the leading position globally, to lead the way, to engage in the future. And there are three components to simplify the whole model where we believe we need to get really engaged as well on an EU level. One is to create a really strong single market with the highest possible level of efficiency, where really digitalization leads the way, where investments lead the way. and cooperation among member states. And here I'm already inviting you never to forget that the Commission is not something out there for the purpose of itself, but we are there to serve people. But we can do that only if you get engaged. Don't forget, we are in a society that needs an engagement. Democracy needs an engagement. Otherwise, you end up with something that then you just complain about. So really, please engage yourself on all levels. We have many platforms. We have many different sessions, conferences, dialogues, where we try to get a good input from the communities, from the stakeholders, from different associations in order to act upon. You know how the saying is in the computer industry, garbage in, garbage out. So let's claim responsibility together for what we do. And there are ways to really claim the power of decision making. So do it. So on a single European market is efficiency the core priority. On global market, our core motivation is to ensure proper connectivity, competitive connectivity, to be connected with markets that are growing markets, to co-create them, which means different standards and full engagement with international institutions like IMO. So whichever standards, or better say regulatory frameworks, we can push on a global level, better for us, better for shipping industry, because shipping, if nothing else, is a global business. Of course, the third element that comes in, which we are putting special emphasis in, is innovation. And innovation really drives the changes. But innovation is not only technical innovation. Innovation is also business modeling, is social innovation, the way how interact with each other, the way how clusters are formed and corporations are manifested. And that brings me to the core that connects all three core elements, which is everything we do, every single move we make, is not for ships, it's not for ports, it's not for railways or airplanes, it is for us, for people. So I'm inviting you that no matter what kind of decision you're going to do in maritime, ask yourselves who will benefit from it and how much. And I hope that I gave you at least some chapeau overview of the major strategic directions that we are going after, and everything else somehow falls in this triangle with a very strong people-oriented connotation.
So the 315 billion euro of Juncker investment plan will include the shipping future in Greece?
Absolutely.
Great. So let's go to some more questions, please.
Καλό μεσημέρι, κυρία Επίτροπος, και στους διοργανωτάς και σε όλους τους επισήμους και στα παιδιά. Τοποθέτηση και όχι ερώτηση. Ξέρουμε ότι η ελληνική ναυτιλία είναι ένα τεράστιο κεφάλαιο για την Ελλάδα, είναι η βαριά βιομηχανία της Ελλάδος.
Αλλά επειδή και το όνομά σας, λίγο.
Το όνομά μου είναι Γιώργος Παρασκευάς, υποπλοίαρχος είμαι στο εμπορικό ναυτικό. Την περασμένη εβδομάδα κατέβηκα από ένα ελληνόχτο δεξαμενόπλιο.
Τέλεια.
Και ήρθα να παρακολουθήσω εδώ τα
προσπάθεια. Τέλεια, μαζί. Τέλεια. Ευχαριστούμε πολύ.
Λοιπόν, ξέρουμε λοιπόν ότι είναι ένα τεράστιο κεφάλαιο για την Ελλάδα. Η Ελλάδα είναι έτερος στην Ευρωπαϊκή Ένωση, άρα μιλάμε και για ένα κεφάλαιο, ευρωπαϊκό κεφάλαιο. Πυκνά, όχι πολύ πυκνά, μάλλον αραιά, ακούγονται κάποιες φωνές, κριτικάρουν την ελληνική ναυτιλία κλπ. Και από την Ευρώπη και γενικότερα. Θα ήθελα να τοποθετηθώ και να ρωτήσω την κυρία Επίτροπο, αυτή η βαριά βιομηχανία για τη χώρα μας, για την Ευρώπη, πρέπει να έχει μία στήριξη από την Ευρωπαϊκή Επιτροπή και από τους άλλους εταίρους, ώστε να προχωρήσει και στον 21ο αιώνα και να συνεχίσει να δίνει αυτές τις θέσεις εργασίας που δίνει στο πλοίο και στη στεριά, σε παγκόσμιο επίπεδο και σε ελληνικό επίπεδο. Και εφόσον οι εταίροι μας θέλουν να βοηθήσουν τη χώρα μας να φύγει από αυτή την κρίση που τη μαστίζει την οικονομική, πρέπει με όλες τις δυνάμεις τους να στηρίξουν την ελληνική ναυτιλία, γιατί η ελληνική ναυτιλία είναι και η ευρωπαϊκή ναυτιλία. Ευχαριστώ.
Well, we are extremely proud of Greek shipping industry. You are part of Europe. We are all Europeans, and your shipping industry is European shipping industry. So I think you you are aware of that, but you'd be surprised how many times I get criticized, but that just is an encouragement for improvement and for open constructive dialogue. So I'm glad that yesterday and today we had a very constructive dialogues with your ministry, with your stakeholders, and I believe that things are going in the right direction.
Great. Question there, please. Thank you. Tonom, your name and where you come from? You speak in English? Greek.
Hi, everybody. My name is George Vognatis. I'm starting to become captain. I'm in Maritime Academy. First of all, I would like to thank you, Mrs. Congratulations. I have already connected with you. You have beautiful thoughts, awesome. Already, you said very good things. However, I would like to something about, as you are a politician, you don't think that the world of 2016 is coming against of the shipping. I believe that the world nowadays is in chaos, is in mess. However, when we are trying to become better person and improve our shipping industry, it's a little bit, not difficult, but ridiculous. How can I explain it easier? It's a little bit... αυτό που θέλω να πω ότι είναι κάπως αστείο το γεγονός ότι ενώ ταυτόχρονα προσπαθούμε να αναβαθμίσουμε την ναυτιλία, την χώρα μας, αλλά και σε όλο τον κόσμο, ο κόσμος βαδίζει από το κακό στο χειρότερο χωρίς να υπάρχει κάποια αισιοδοξία ή φως στο τούνελ. Ευχαριστώ πάρα πολύ. Να είστε καλά.
The world is in a very dynamic stage. And with globalization coming so strong forward as a global orientation, of course, we are challenged by many, many unforeseen and never experienced situations. Like Europe, we've never had immigration crisis, refugee crisis before, never. Europeans were always leaving Europe. This is the first time that somebody wants to come to Europe. So of course we were shocked. Of course we were unready for such a massive, massive movement. But we're dealing with it. We're dealing with it step by step. And in such a short time, we actually have addressed it, and we will continue to address it. And this is not the end of the story, because strong migrations, refugee movements will be part of the future for many years to come. So we really have to do the job well now, when we can still actually manage it in a good way. On the other hand, please go back to the historical books and tell me in which century you would rather be born than in this one. I don't want to go back to any other century. Think about diseases, think about all kinds of challenges and problems that nations of previous centuries had. Tell me in which one would you like to go, 14th century, 16th century, 18th century? 5th BC? Well, there was a glory of Greece, yes, I understand. Okay. Bring it back. So, that's why my invitation is so strong. You are creators of the future. You might think that you are small and unimportant, but that's your problem. Then you have to work on your personal development. You are very important. Each and single one of you can create world. I create it. I keep creating it. On all different levels, and I never felt that I cannot do it. I can, of course I can, and that's your buzzword, yes. Say yes to shipping. So make sure that you don't ever lose this understanding that you create the world and connect with others. 10, you're stronger. 100, you're even stronger. Thousands, you're even more, you're stronger. But imagine 1 million people, 2 million people, 10 million people, 1 billion people getting together. But that starts in the grassroots, starts from bottom up. And I know that we can create, and we are creating, and we will create a better world. And allow me, because we are close to an end to this session, I'd like to invite you also that you're smart. You can see things. Think about the values of EU that we all are so badly now treating as a concept itself. Think under the conditions that EU was formed, and what is the fundamental mission of EU? Do you know? The fundamental mission of the founding fathers was that they're going to create a unity of nations in a way that the neighbor will never even think about attacking a neighbor. In other words, that they will create a peace, that they will create a union where peace will always exist. And this is the record time that in the territory of Europe, within EU, we haven't had any war, 65 years. So please value that. I know you're young. I know you've never experienced war. I haven't. But my grandmother did, and my mother was born in the war. I don't want to live those times ever again. I don't want to. So I do everything I can in order to sustain that and at the same time to have fun.
Amazing. Just the last. It is a question.
Yes.
Great. And then just Mr. Vodon is a quick. He wants just quickly to say because Ms. Commissioner must go. Okay. Please.
Okay. Good morning from me. My name is Konstantina Kosmidou. I work at the Ministry of Infrastructure, Transport, and Networks here in Athens. So literally, I am a cousin to shipping. I have a rather strange question for you, but then again, almost every question is a little strange. This forum is mostly, primarily addressed to young people. As it says, it is a Young Executives Shipping Forum. So let's say that we have some people who are not so young. They are not 20 years old or 25, but they still feel very young in their hearts. After all,
like me.
Yes. Or like me. We are Greek people, and Greek people, as you know, we are young until the day we die. So here is the question. What could you recommend, what could you advise, if there is any advice, for a person who is not so young? He or she already has a job, but he's fascinated by the shipping, and not just shipping industry, but mostly shipping ideal, especially in Greece. He or she would like to occupy, to engage with maritime and shipping. What would you advise to her? Thank you very much.
My first advice would be afraid of advisors. And instead of share stories and share visions. I would just share my own story. I'm not that young anymore, but I'm really young in my heart, and I know I'm going to live long. I try to get all the time engaged with people that I can share my passion and vision with. And through that, I get inspired. Every time I get inspired. So on one hand is this engagement with people. Don't close yourself in a room and not get out. So engage. The other one is always try to learn something new. This drive for knowledge, it's something so amazing. And it equips you with the tools. Because knowledge, whichever you get, it's old. You know that, yeah? It's like a fruit, you know? It's only good for a short period of time. But the tools itself are incredible because they tell you about the variety of possible solutions, variety of possible approaches. And on the top of that, build and create your own. Yeah? So this drive for just be creative and drive for be engaged and connected with others, it's something that works for me, and I hope it will work for you as well. And they say, an old Buddhist saying says, more we are connected, more we are free. And I invite you to think about it because it's a really powerful message.
Mr. Manolis Vordonis, okay, he, I will not say that he has a big history because he also feels young. So he will
you
say.
You came for the young people, but allow an old man to express his joy. Commissioner, European Commissioner Violeta Bulc, I'm sorry. Violeta Bulc, you are tall. You are lively. You are an engineer. You are a computer woman. You're a dreamer. You're a lover. You're inspiring us. You are Slovenian. You are Balkanic. Correct. You are the Zorba in the European Commission. So, I think we have to celebrate the fact that a bureaucratic system in Brussels has chosen a woman like you to lead the position of the Shipping and Transport Commission. And a proposal and a request from the white hair is, from your so critical position, be as a dreamer and as an optimist and as practical and pragmatic and say yes to shipping.
Yes to shipping.
Yes. So, this is a woman and a man ready to dance Zorba. So, first Young Executive Shipping Forum, you came here. We want to have you again also next year and the year after. Thank you very much.
And don't forget, Europe needs you.